A cocktail of factors, including the effects of COVID-19 on the supply chain, the resurgence of the global demand, and new tax regimes in East Africa have been blamed for causing skyrocketing fuel prices in Uganda. The pump prices in the capital, Kampala, have spiked, with a liter of petrol going for as high as between 4,500 and 5,000 shillings, while diesel is quoted at 3,999 shillings to 4,200 per liter.
The economy is not performing simply because government has crowded out finances and spent it on what? On classified, on vehicles, which you don't manufacture, okay? So you import all that what you spend on. So as you have a huge demand on importation, the dollar prices go up. Consequently, they will drive the fuel prices up.
It's upon this crisis that the Parliamentary Committee on National Economy has asked the government to release whatever fuel they have in the reserves to mitigate fuel prices.
Let government be in a position to release the reserves, so that this will act as a buffer to mitigate on the skyrocketing price of fuel. Currently, if you look at the price of fuel, the price of one liter of diesel is at 4,200 and something, and of petrol is almost 4,600. So it's really alarming.
The committee is concerned that the escalating trend of fuel prices is going to rub salt in the wound of a staggering economy, which is just recovering from negative effects of the pandemic.
Right now, we are faced with even a bigger challenge of inflation, given the increasing prices of fuel in our country. I think we need to control, we need to forecast such events that are happening in our country and get solutions prior to the events happening, because right now the increase in the prices of fuel will automatically trigger increases in the prices of goods in our country, and that will bring inflation in our country, which will usher in even more problems for our country.
This is entirely affects the entire economy, because when you look at the factories which use fuel for production, their production costs have gone high. Transportation for goods and people who are also in the service industry, the cost has gone high. The employee costs, individual costs of doing business now, of running around, has gone so high. So the government must come out clearly to stabilize. Government must intentionally invest in the fuel sector in this country.
Normally, the prices go up as a result of scarcity. But we believe that once government releases what is in the reserves, it basically has an impact. It will definitely mitigate. It will cushion the pump prices, and it will bring it slightly lower, or it will cause a balance.
The Shadow Minister of Finance, Mwanga Chivumbi, has implored the government to control capital flight, where key players in the economy are multinational companies which repatriate a lot of money every single day.
There's a lot of capital flight. There is a lot of money, okay? Because you have a liberal economy. I mean, MTN, Stanbic Bank, and other things, as they make money, all these companies you see, in the evening, they need dollars to wear their money out of the country. So when you don't domesticate and give you nationals a huge stake in the economy, okay, the demand for Forex will always be high.
He called for policies that will domesticate the economy. However, the government chief whip, Thomas Tayebo, has assured the public that the government is monitoring fuel prices closely, and very soon a solution will be available.
The only solution we shall have is if we continue supporting our oil and gas sector, so that we process our oil from here, we start supplying ourselves from here, and we don't depend on international market to bring it. But for now, we have to watch the international market closely, because government has not increased the taxes. on oil.
Yesterday, the Minister of State for Energy, Sidronius Okasai Opolot, advised Ugandans to tighten their belts since the government is not ready to intervene to lower the rising fuel prices.
There is very little that we can do on international crude oil price. But at country level, we actually regulate the prices to match the global trend. So whatever is happening there, it is not the private sector is not doing it without government intervention. Government regularly reviews the prices according to the global trends.
This report by Fred Kajubi for the news.